The techniques used in brain-machine interfaces. Brain-machine interfaces, BMIs, employ a variety of techniques to facilitate communication between the human brain and external devices. Here's a breakdown of some key techniques. Signal acquisition. BMIs can be based on different types of input signals such as single unit activity, recording from individual neurons. Electrocorticography, ECOG recording from the cortical surface. Electroencephalography, EEG recording electrical activity from the scalp. Magnetic resonance imaging, MRI, and magnetoencephalography, MEG imaging techniques that capture brain activity. Multiphoton imaging, visualizing neuronal population activity, signal processing. Novel techniques are used to interpret these signals, including deep learning, for classifying patterns in brain signals. Algorithms, developed for accurate decoding of cognitive states. Interface methods. The two main methods to interface with the brain are electroencephalography, EEG interprets electrical signals from the brain. Electromyography, EMG interprets signals from muscles. Operation steps. The operation of BCIs generally involves four steps: measure, recording brain data, interpret, deciphering the user's intended action, encode, translating information into a format a computer can use, deploy, executing the process data to perform a task. These techniques are crucial for the development of BCIs that can enhance human cognitive and sensorimotor capabilities, with applications ranging from healthcare to gaming and virtual reality. The technical processes using brain-machine interfaces. The technical processes involved in brain-machine interfaces, BMIs, can be quite complex. But here's a simplified explanation of the key steps. Signal acquisition. This is the first step, where the BMI system captures brain signals. Techniques like EEG, electroencephalography, or ECOG, electrocorticography, are used to record electrical activity. Signal processing. The raw signals are often noisy and not directly interpretable. Signal processing involves filtering the noise and decoding the signals to understand the user's intention. This might involve machine learning algorithms or pattern recognition systems. Feature extraction. This step involves identifying the specific aspects of the brain's signals that correlate with particular thoughts or commands. Machine learning. The extracted features are then fed into machine learning models that have been trained to associate certain signal patterns with specific commands. Control interface. The interpreted signals are translated into commands for an external device, such as a robotic arm or a computer cursor. Feedback. Finally, the user receives feedback from the controlled device, which can be visual, tactile, or auditory. This feedback is crucial for the user to adjust their brain signals and improve the control over the interface. These processes allow BMIs to translate thoughts into actions, enabling users to control external devices just by thinking. Explanation of closed-loop versus open-loop systems. Here's a comparison between closed-loop and open-loop systems. Closed-loop systems feedback controlled. They use feedback to adjust the system's actions based on the output, self-regulating. They continuously monitor the output and compare it with the desired goal, making adjustments as needed. Complex construction. They are generally more complex due to the feedback mechanism, high accuracy. The feedback loop allows for more precise control, making them accurate, stable. They are less prone to disturbances because of the feedback optimization. They can be optimized for better performance. Examples: thermostats, cruise control in vehicles, and modern air conditioners. Open-loop systems know feedback. They operate without monitoring or adjusting based on the output. Simple construction. They are simpler and often more cost-effective to implement, less accurate. Without feedback, they can be less accurate and more affected by disturbances. Stable. They are generally stable but can't adjust to changes or errors. No optimization. They cannot be optimized based on the output performance. Examples: traffic lights, basic washing machines, and manual water heaters. In essence, closed loop systems are better suited for applications requiring high precision and adaptability, while open loop systems are used where simplicity and cost are more critical than control accuracy. The way feedback loops be implemented in BMIs. Feedback loops in brain machine interfaces, BMIs, can be implemented through a process that involves real-time monitoring and adjustment of the system based on the user's intentions and the performance of the BMI. Here's a general outline of how it can be done. Data acquisition. the BMI system captures neural signals using techniques like EEG or invasive electrodes, signal decoding. These signals are then decoded using algorithms such as Kalman filters or neural networks to interpret the user's intended movement or action execution. The decoded intentions are translated into commands that control an external device, like a robotic arm or a computer cursor. Feedback provision. The user receives feedback from the external device, which could be visual, auditory, or through sensory stimulation adjustment. The system uses this feedback to adjust the decoding algorithms in real time, improving the accuracy and reliability of the BMI. For example, a closed-loop BMI might use an optimal feedback control model to infer the user's motor intention and adapt the system's response with every spike event. This allows for dynamic control and can lead to more robust and efficient BMIs. Additionally, control theoretic frameworks can be applied to optimize decoder performance. Addressing challenges like neural plasticity, implementing feedback loops is crucial for the development of adaptive BMIs that can provide more natural and intuitive control for the user. The way neural adaptation affect BMI performance over time. Neural adaptation can significantly impact the performance of brain-machine interfaces, BMIs, over time. Here's how learning and improvement. As users interact with BMIs, their brains undergo neural plasticity, which is the process of learning and forming new neural connections. This can lead to improved performance as the user becomes more adept at controlling the interface. Decoder adaptation. BMIs often use adaptive decoders that can change in response to the user's neural activity. As the brain learns, the decoder can also adjust, leading to a more personalized and efficient system. Skill retention. With continued use, the changes in the brain can become more stable, allowing for skill retention. This means that users can maintain a high level of performance even after periods of non-use. Resistance to interference. Neural adaptation can make the BMI control more resistant to interference from the brain's native motor networks. This is particularly important when BMIs are used in conjunction with natural movements. Performance plateaus. Over time, the rate of improvement in BMI performance may slow down as the user and the system reach a plateau. Further performance gains might require new training strategies or system updates. Long-term reliability. Neural adaptation contributes to the long-term reliability of BMIs. As the brain and the decoder adapt to each other, the system can become more robust against external changes and disturbances. In summary, neural adaptation is a double-edged sword. It can lead to significant improvements in BMI performance, but can also result in performance plateaus that require innovative solutions to overcome.